Let me introduce our next guest for the day, Mr. Prasad Patil. Sir, may I have your permission to please begin? Thank you, sir. Sir describes himself as an accidental marathoner. He is also trainer and coach at various running events held in Pune. Sir loves training and holding the beginners, also helping trainers taking off their fitness goals. Sir also loves teaching on emotional quotient. We also welcome Kritika Shukla ma'am. With this, I request sir to kindly address the batch.
So out of 10 people they come to me, most of 9 people they seen by someone, either the spouse saying मेरे हस्बैंड को लेके जाओ और भगाओ और मेरे वाइफ को भगाओ और माय सन को भगाओ और द एम्प्लॉयज द बॉस इज मेरे एम्प्लॉय को भगाओ. सो यू आर इन विच कैटेगरी एंड देर आर वन पर्सन बिकॉज द सक्सेस डिपेंड्स ऑन द पर्सन हु कम्स फॉरवर्ड यू. He say, I want to do this activity. You are in which category? Which one? So how many people they want to run? Oh, everyone, 100%. Wow. Why? Why do you want to run? Anyone? Why do you want to run? Come on, it's a difficult question.
Good evening, sir. My name is Bharti Gokarn. I am from Varanasi, Uttar Pradesh. Sir, I want to run because it will keep me healthy and fit and flexible also.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Do you agree with her? Yes, sir. Do you appreciate what the fitness and health is?
Yes.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Really?
Yes, sir.
What time you get up in the morning? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
What time you go to the bed?
11.
Let's understand. Every actions of ours has a different motive. First thing, we do it for our physical need. Second is for our mental needs. Second is emotional needs. And some actions we do for our economic needs. These are the basic needs for us human beings. But then as far as the fitness and health is concerned, at least when I was studying, I was not that appreciative. Because no matter how abusive your lifestyle is, everything is taken care by nature. Without your contribution, your health is maintained by design. Everything is growing in your life. Everything is growing. Your height is growing, your brain is growing, your skin is growing, your ambitions are growing. And at this age, we don't appreciate the fitness and the health. I will not buy this because I want to run for fitness. Could be one of the reasons. You will show up for one or two runs, that's okay. But you will not get addicted, for sure. As far as the economy is concerned, whether you will win the marathon, I don't think so chances. Because the Kenyans, they run for money. And they beat everyone around the world. Where we run in 4 hours or 5 hours in full marathon, they run in 2 hours. For money also we can run. In fact, you are running or not running physically, all the time you are running. You are running into future, you are running. All the time we are running. Where we run, you know? Where we run? We run in our mind. We are running from one feeling to other. And all the time we are running towards something or running away from something. All the time. The two basic emotions where the human being runs. For example, there was a match, World Cup match against the Pakistan, and a lot of, I know most of the people, they love following the cricket. Recall the World Cup match against the Pakistan, India won. And now no one wants to stay home. Everyone wants out, running around and showing your joy. As a child, whenever we feel joy, the child is not, you don't want to sit at one place, you want to run around. And the second reason we run is when we feel fear. For example, you commit something to your faculty, okay? The submission or some commitment you are given to, and you know very well you are not able to fulfill the commitment. That time what do? Even seeing the faculty, we run away. You promise something to your parents and you know you are not able to fulfill that commitment. We run away from there. So every time we are running towards something or running away from something. But then, as a human being, we have been given very true strong emotion. Because of those two strong emotions, we survive in this world. Which are those emotions? One is a fear, another is greed. And these are the positive emotions. These are the both the positive emotions. As long as we know how much fear is important, how much greed is important. Now, in case your dominant emotion is fear, all the time fear is driving you. All the time. That also breeds fear of loss. A lot of things our human body designs supports that claim. Cheetah is the fastest runner. He runs 96 miles per hour certain distance. Afterwards, he has to stop for breathing. He cannot breathe and run. He has to stop for breathing, otherwise his heart gets exploded without the oxygen. He has to stop. Whereas human being can breathe and run. A deer vanishes in next second. But he cannot run and cool down his body. He has to stop to cool down his body. Whereas human being can run with our sweat glands, our body temperature is maintained. And that makes us longest joggers. There are races happening against the horse riders, 100 mile race. Out of 10 race, couple of times human being beats the horse riders. This is the ability we have as a human beings. Those time when no weapons was developed, human being was depends on either the vegetables or the animals to survive. There no way to hunting. And then scientists, they says how they used to catch their food. For example, deer they spotted, they vanish in next seconds. But human being is to run, track down the deer. After certain time, deer has to stop looking for any danger. Again, he sees the danger, looking at the person, they start running. And one point of time, his body heats so high, get exhausted and dies. And human being goes and catch him. This is the way we survived as a human beings. Now why I am telling you this story, even today, whether world is dangerous? Maybe. Those time there was a physical danger. Those physical danger we are not having today. In fact, we are living in the most peaceful era in entire human history. Most peaceful. There is no conflict happening against country, against the other country. Even religion conflict are at very minimal this thing. Even 100 years back there are hundreds of thousands and millions of people used to die in the wars, in the conflict. Today we are living in the most peaceful era. There is no physical danger so far. Occasional there are issues, but not as much. But there are emotional and mental issues. These are created by our own thinking, our own emotions. And whenever we feel fear of losing something, suppose I don't get the job, suppose I don't get to find a partner, right partner, suppose I lose the relationship, I lose the health, all the time is running into us. To deal with this, philosophy says, don't worry, be happy. Everyone knew. But how? That's a big question. How? And when we don't know how to handle the situation, we want distraction. So that's the reason some people get distracted to smoking or alcohol or some other distraction. And the few other like us, we get distracted by running. I started purely for my own distraction. When I hit my own mid-career or mid-life crisis, I was not able to handle it. And then one day I was walking in the area in ITI Road. There I saw four runners. They were running in perfect rhythm. Their body were relaxed, head were high, shoulders were out, back was straight, knees in bent condition. Perfect rhythm. I don't know who the runner were, but that one sight still hit me so intensely inside. And from that moment onwards, I am the same person. And everything changed in my life. Everything changed in my life. And then I realized, when you hit 30, 35, no? In case you are not growing, you die. At the age of 25, 20 to 25, everything is taken care of by nature. From now onwards, suppose you don't grow, only two things happens. Either you die or you grow. If you are not growing, you are dying from that moment. Your ambition, your goals, your fitness, your health, your relationship, your skills. If you are not growing from that moment, you are dying. And how you grow? Only by changing you grow. That thing doesn't change, doesn't grow, and that thing doesn't grow, dies. Is a pure law. Seed, suppose it doesn't change to the sapling, it dies as a seed. It has to change to the sapling. Sapling changes to the plant. Plant has changed to the tree, and tree has to bear the fruit. Same way, as a student or in your area of expertise, are you growing? That is very, very important. Till that, everything is taken care of. Your parents have paid for your all the fees, or nature has paid everything. You bring a lot of resources from all the world, consume. Till that, you are come here. Suppose from here you want to grow, you need to change something. The way you study, the way you work, the way you develop your skills, the way you are associated the company with. Every time You need to change. Good change. I'm not saying you have to, good change. Wherever you align with the law of gravity, you are most efficient as far as the energy is concerned. So I started running, and then I realized running is such a fantastic activity we want to share with entire our world. Now this world is not our world. Our world is the people, they know us. We can't conquer the entire world. No human being ever has conquered the human world. Even the Alexander conquered the world. The known world was, he was conquered. Sachin Tendulkar conquered the cricket world. Roger Federer conquered the tennis world. No human being the conquered entire world. Whether you can conquer your own world, yes, that's possible. The family, it matters. The friends circle, you matters. The society, that matters, that you know, that you can conquer for sure. And that I started conquering. And once you conquer this, your own world, you can expand that one. And then running helped me doing that. And today I can claim that thousands of people I change by helping them, giving that confidence. Even whatever age, you can start. It doesn't matter. For example, suppose I ask you, what is my age is? 35 plus, okay. You know what? You know what? It doesn't matter. I am feeling already good. Whatever age you are, from there you can start. There are Fauja Singh, he started running marathons at the age of 90. Today has 104, he run full marathon. And there are younger people in the schools, they also run. But in case you want to deal with the pressure and the stress and the world, at which the world is changing, you want to cope up with the change, running is the fantastic activity, fantastic activity. Everything changes in your life, because this is one thing, you will not keep it to yourself, you want to, your friends has to run, your mother has to run, everyone you will inspire and motivate, and this fills with a lot of energy, you will become passionate, and that energy you will bring to your studies, to your own goals, to your own skills. And running only can provide that, because it's quite natural to human beings. Very, very natural to us. Now, while you run, first of all, your head should be high. Because for muscles, oxygen is energy. You need oxygen. In case you are running head down, first of all, you are not efficient as far as the gravity is concerned or posture is concerned. And second thing is, suppose you are running like this, you are choking the oxygen pipe. There's a reason your head should be high. Your oxygen pipe is open for more oxygen. Second thing, while running or jogging, you should able to speak a sentence or sing a song. Suppose you start jogging or running tomorrow, should able to speak an entire sentence or sing a song. Whenever you are not able to do that, it means your heart rate gone to the roof. There is no point in persisting. This is not a 100 meter dash. This is a long distance. This is the way marathon been run. While you run, your breathing should be under control. How would you know that? You should able to speak a sentence. You don't need to measure your heart rate, but this is an indicator. When you are panting for the breath, it means your heart rate gone to the roof. There is no pointing. Slow down. Get your breathing under control. Again start. Even you walk in the marathon is okay, there is no foul. Even you walk in the marathon is okay. And again you start. Again you start. You start running and you are not able to speak a sentence. Again slow down. Get back your breathing. Again start. This is the way you build your stamina. Maybe you will be able to run few 100 meters. You will panting for the breath. Stop down. Walk for certain distance. Again you start. Again. Now, suppose you have an ambition of running in a half marathon or marathon, this is the way you need to build your stamina. Now, given the fact that could be a better runner than him, he may be better runner than her, she may be better runner than him. This is all relative, it doesn't matter. But then, water is at 25 degrees. You started heating it. This goes up to 30, then 35, then 40. Suppose you stop heating, where it goes? Go back to 25. Again you start heating, 30, 40, 50, 60, you leave it. It goes back to, you start again heating, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. You leave it, again you go back. Start heating it, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. When the transformation happens, when the liquid gets transformed into the vapor form. Same thing about even running. Start hitting every single day, consistently showing up. Hitting you. Once you hit the 100, then even 2 months, 3 months, suppose you don't do any exercises, still you can run an half marathon because you already hit the critical point. That's possible. Given the fact there are coaches available, there are trainers available, please come and run with us. Understand the breathing technique, how to build your all the muscles from toe to head. Get trained to ourselves. It is much easier for you. It's much easier for you. Yes, please. Body relaxed, head high, shoulders out, back straight, and knees in bent condition. Now, given the fact that we are blessed to live in a Pune, the fantastic weather, all weather we can run. Now, while running, your body should be relaxed. Now, this is the way I run because when you go to the office, there is a office or the college is matrix driven. Abhi terminal exam hai, phir viva hai, there is a matrix. You are miserable there. Considering, not all of you, but when you go back, your family is a matrix. Don't bring that matrix to running. Because I don't bring matrix to, there should be a goal, but then a lot of people, they are so much into watching their heart rate and the timing, they miss the smile on the route. Should able to greet each and every person who are cheering you back, then you feel the energy. Suppose tomorrow morning you are running, how many smile you want to grab? As many as possible. She was there yesterday. And suppose you get bored on this, you can change because this is the freedom we have. We enjoy in freedom. As a human being, we love freedom and running brings you that. So always what the posture is, head high, shoulders out, back straight, knees in bent condition. Now our feet has arch. That arch is not simply there, it's given by design to us. It's a perfectly designed arch for us. And because of arch is compressed and elongated, is as like a suspension bridge. And because of that arch, we are able to move forward. When you hit the ground, 8 to 10 times of the body weight is impact on the ground. Now, no shoes in the world take the impact. Impact is absorbed by the entire skeleton. 1/3 of the bones, they purely act like a suspension. So that is the reason posture is very, very important. Okay, now that arch to toe, this is a part, it's called midfoot. So our landing should be on the midfoot. Okay, now how we teach that arch, you imagine as a diameter of the ball. You're running on the ball all the time. Make sure that your shoes are not restricting the arch movement, that flexibility. At times it interferes with your how the your feet flex. Okay, now what happens is Suppose your posture is not right itself, because it deformed because of your lifestyle, and suppose your right leg is stronger than the left leg, the body, what body does is to protect the weaker, it gives all the stronger. Suppose you are injured and you are running, your ankle is twisted, still you want to run. To protect that injured leg, all the load goes through this. It's become stronger, this is getting weaker. Without even realizing, this happens. Having said this technique, you have to run on the ball. We can't run on consciously all the time, whether we should breathe through nose or mouth or running on the ball or the midfoot. You can't do consciously. The best way to do is you have to go and sit on the football field, watch the children playing, how they run. They are the most natural form. Observe their action, observe their action, observe their action, absorb, absorb, absorb. And then while you run, relax. You start doing exercises with us. Whichever there is a postural deformity, we correct it. And then we'll be efficient as a. At this age, I don't see they got a form, basic form. It get deformed later on. So I'm not really concerned about their form. Yes, please.
My name is Sahard Giri.
So
my question to you is how to keep us motivated to run? Because one day we wake up at 5, we do it for 2 days, then the third day we think that let's have a sleep, and then we doesn't do it.
Okay. So. See, no one is lazy in the world, but then we have a lazy goals. Suppose, given the fact that you all the people love the picnic, where you will get up in the morning, everyone?
Yes.
Right? So it depends what you are looking up to. If you don't fix up the goal, it won't motivate you. For example, there are football team, with all the efforts, you take the ball, with all the juggling and sifting, you take the ball towards the one corner of the football field. And there you saw there is no goal post. How you will feel? Whether you will be interested in that game? Suppose there is a match going between the Pune and Mumbai. Mumbai win the toss, and here is the Pune team for the batting. While taking the guard, the batsman realized there is no stumps. Even the fielder realized there is no stumps. And there is no boundary lines, the boundary rope has been removed. Whether the players will be interested in that game, whether the spectator you are watching will be interested in that game. We need to have certain goals, why you want to run. Reason should be very strong. If that is not there, we are not focused, it doesn't motivate us. That's the only thing. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for such a motivational session, for enlightening us on various aspects of desire, greed, danger, etc., and most importantly, teaching us the importance of running. Thank you once again.